to Newmarket High School. Put your hands up. Okay? How many folks found someone who have kids or grandkids in any of the schools here? Put your hands up. Okay. So there's a lot of folks here who have an investment in the school system, so I just wanted you to see that number of folks around. All right. I'm going to start with a little bit of history of how we got here, very, very brief. There's a couple of tasks that we want to do this evening. Before I get to the meat of the task, the very first most important thing is, how late do you want to go this evening? 9 o'clock? So as we did last time, we said about 8:30 we would check in and see where we were and see if we wanted to go more time, but definitely 9 o'clock is our upper limit. Is that okay? All right. So if folks would help me out and keep an eye on the time and let me know if we miss one of those timelines, so we know what our timeline is. Okay, a little bit of history to date. Kathy made copies of notes from previous meetings. Now actually what you have there is a combined set of notes from both of the first two meetings. And those are the things that are getting posted on the website. So there's a copy at each table just in case you need to refer back to them. Okay, we won't necessarily have to, but it's there as a resource. And what had we done up to this point? In our very first meeting, we spent some time, besides getting to know each other, trying to identify the types of information that we thought would be useful to have in terms of thinking about school facilities. We spent some time thinking about the mechanisms by which we're going to gather information from the community and get information back to the community. Then we also thought through that and created a prioritized list of what do we really think we needed to do next. So you notice at the end of those notes, there's a list of things with some numbers, and there's numbers with the tallies of the things we had listed up here on the wall, and they've just been rearranged from the highest to the lowest. So based on that, we did two actions. One is we scheduled this meeting, and the second was a survey was generated, okay, and was put out to the community. We had several folks help us with that. I'm just going to identify one of the person who helped with that is sitting here. This is Mary Jean. I got your name correct?
Mary Jane.
Mary Jane. The letters I have rearranged. Okay. So Mary Jane is here. She helped with that process as well as Forrest Ransdell, who's on the school board, and Sue Caswell, who's our administrative account. What's her official title?
Business managers.
Okay. So the survey that went out that some of you have, and we're going to be looking at here shortly, was following the kind of design issues that we talked about, and that got out, and I believe it had a return date of today, which worked out well for us because then we have some stuff to take a look at this evening. And we thank them very much for that because many hands make light work. So thank you. Okay. All right, so what I want to do this evening is start taking a look at this stuff. And certainly a person could sit down and do it, but it's a much easier task if many folks are involved in this and you get a chance to look and see what folks are saying. So what we're going to do is we're going to review all the responses that we have to date, and we have emails that folks have sent in as well as hard copies. Some of you folks may have copies that you brought with you. You can either hang on to those or you can have me put them in the pile, because what I'm going to do here is I'm going to distribute them to all of the groups. So if you want them in the pile, I'd be happy to include them. Or if you want to hang on to them, hang on. So looks like we're hanging on to them. Okay. So we're going to review the responses and kind of try to get some sense of what folks are saying. And that's what these things are for. Okay. And we're also going to do an assessment of the survey process, because we did something to try to gather some information, and we're going to evaluate the quality of that process. So it's not just the content, but it's also the process that's important. So we're going to spend some time talking about that. So here's your assignment. I'm going to give each table some of the emailed responses and a stack of some of the individual responses, and you can include your own in that pile if you've got some at your own table. And what I'd like you to do is the following. I'd like you at your table is to read the responses to each other so that everybody at that table can hear what an individual is saying. Otherwise, you can't all share. We don't have copies for each other, so you're going to have to work with each other. And rotate the reader roll around the table so that not everybody's reading all the time. As you're going, someone in your group, please keep notes, because what you want to start doing is, what are the themes that are there? Remember, we asked folks what their questions were or what their comments or issues are. We want to start categorizing them. All right? So that's going to be a process that evolves as you look at the data. You can look at central questions that people bring up, or issues, or particular attitudes or emotions that are being expressed there. Don't evaluate the comment. So if someone says something, you're reading it, you really don't agree with that, it's not your job to say whether you agree or disagree with that particular comment. Okay? The job of the group is to say, what are the issues or questions that are being expressed there? Because we're trying to get a consensus in the sense of what the community is feeling about what issues they have and what questions they have. It's not our job as a small segment of the community to criticize what folks are saying. Okay? So as you continue, categorize things. If you find similar things coming back again, you don't have to create new categories. You can fold them together. You can reword the categories. And after a reasonable length of time, and it will take some time to process these at your tables, I'll start debriefing and pulling out those summary issues or questions, and we're going to start putting them up here. Now, as we do that, I suspect you're going to find some commonalities, things recurring, and so we're not going to have to report out absolutely everything that everybody has. Just a second. This is an efficient way for all of us to hear everybody's voices as we're doing stuff. Now, before we get going, let's questions that you have about the process.
I had a couple of questions along the process.
Yep.
The first one is my suggestion would be, as we are evaluating, we find common themes, is to keep track of, say, 5 people ask the same question, 10 people ask the same question, so that we can get a feel for how the majority of the responders
try to have a tally as we go.
Yes.
So let me ask if folks think that would be a manageable thing to do as you go. Would that be helpful for folks to kind of keep a running tally of things? Okay, I'm not getting a sense either way. Is this a yes?
Yes.
I'm not hearing objections. Okay, all right. So try as you can, once you start getting categories, to try to tally that. That will actually save us some work, because one of the things I was going to suggest is it would be nice to tally. Okay, I have no idea how long this is going to take you. So I'm going to keep checking in to see where folks are with stuff. And if by accident your table happens to be done and not have anything to do, look to one of the other tables to see if they got some extra stuff. All right. So in principle, we'll try to get to the same place at the same time without rushing anybody, with anybody sitting around with nothing to do. Does anybody have any questions of me about the process as I've described it? Okay. The hardest thing you're going to find to do is not to evaluate the comments that you see. Okay? So stick with this as data, glean out the issues or questions, and try to stay on task with getting information from the surveys that folks have been good enough to spend some time writing and returning to us. Okay, let's see if there's anything else I want to say. Okay, again, please, someone at each table is going to need to keep notes and take a tally. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to give every table one of the email responses. And these are a little bit funny because there's more than one survey response on each sheet of paper, but they alternate, italicized, non-italicized, italicized, non-italicized. So you might have 4 or 5 responses on a sheet, okay? Now, the other thing is, along with the evaluation issue, is if someone happens to have put their name on the sheet of paper, That's not important. All right? Because if you're going to avoid evaluating the results, you don't want to do the same stuff. You want to go for the issues and ideas. Okay, as soon as you get those, you can start talking. I'm going to hand out the rest. The folks who are out there, grab a table that only has three or so people and jump in and start helping them out. Doesn't matter where you go. Just introduce yourselves.
So, Christine, I'm Mary Gunn. I'm twice as old as him, and I'm not really from where we came.
Is that
$18,000 per year. And then transporting them.
And you know, that animation actually was.
There's more on this.
This is more of a question, which is about tax credit. So we've got two kinds of taxes, right? So maybe they'll put taxes up here and tally the tax, So this regional, that's why they want the regional part.
Hi, can I help you with something? Surveys were sent out?
Yeah.
These people are analyzing the survey.
Okay, so I am Lane. My name is Eddie. Okay, I was at the National Arts Society.
Actually, can I grab your chair? You can take one of the wooden ones so I can carry this around for us. Nice sighting here with you folks. I just got here from the National Arts Society. Seventh grade, life science here.
Yeah, I think they're being
I'll kind of listen to things. I've been, like you said, down the other building.
It's time to be in this more meeting.
Yeah, exactly.
So what am I writing?
You're writing. We want to be reading. Newmarket, Newmarket has a very large renter population. Lots of women, there's a Newmarket school system. The school board and our town. This is a large tax department. That's all of those renters. There must be some way to fund it as renters who are using school systems instead of making all the taxes.
So not a tax issue again, but focusing on renters.
And then another one is for add-on and improve the existing high school. It costs $18,000 for a school student to attend Marching Pride.
But you're right, the traffic is definitely
Is that we mentioned sports?
Right, are we ready for next one? First, don't tender our kids to their district. It's a rack bear. Considering dissolving the
If you find another group that looks like this, you should be welcome to pass that.
See Chris, he'll give you an assignment.
Okay, just want to get a sense of how much time you need.
Linda.
What we're doing is we're going through the survey. Okay. So, what I suggest is join a group.
Yeah. Bonds due. This one creates excessive tax burden on the taxpayers disproportionately. Newmarket has one of the highest tax rates in the area, but residents do not pay property tax. The need of the needs of the should be less than a priority. A new school does not guarantee quality education, but it does guarantee strive to provide them education setting in time.
No, this is like a 4-week.
Well, they do still, this is the Seco School of Technology, the Seco School of Technology. It's going to be on history engineering, which I know you can understand that. We still can. We still do. Oh, yeah, we have two buses. Yeah, we have two buses that go, one in the morning to the sophomore. I'm sorry, the juniors and one in the afternoon. There's three of them. Go for it. But I mean, that may be what they're referring to also, is taking advantage of some of the programs down there. Or more advantages.
Taking advantage of
the program.
Regionalization is cost effective, and pooling resources allows us to get more for our jobs. The state of Maine is considering more solutions to consolidate.
They're talking about, I think about the 12 or 15 school districts in the United States. About York and Kittrick.
Those groups are done. Does anybody still like a little bit more time?
Yeah.
Okay, anybody else? Okay, so we're going to get 2 more minutes. Is that good for you guys? Okay, 2 more minutes for folks to finish up. And I will get back to you.
Okay. Disingenuous is how one could characterize the board's consideration of alternatives presented to the building of a new school. Are they putting forward options that are not attempted or spirited? Too negative and not too positive. Initially, an outsider assessment presents the following. A. Building a school with barriers is many years off and needs to happen in the short term. B. Portsmouth may be a temporary fix. One downside to Portsmouth is that it would be a long bus ride for kids each day. Long bus rides are expensive. Portsmouth is not a town. It's not a town. It's a town. Towns currently make tuition 2 hours on the top of the becomes an obvious solution. They have recently gone through an expansion renovation. They are in a lot of winning school districts adjacent to ours. Mr. Ramper has one of the strongest.
Okay, I'm going to stop you because we need to move on. It's almost 8 o'clock. It may be that a couple folks still have things to talk about, but maybe we're going to pick up that stuff in the process of debriefing. So everybody just kind of, you've all been engaged continuously for the last 40 minutes. So if you want to, just stand up for a second and, you know, walk around, jump the bag, whatever. Just in place while I describe what we're doing next. Okay? Hard chairs to sit out as well as
I was sitting.
Okay. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to go around one table to the next, and I would like you, you've been categorizing, identifying issues or questions, and kind of summarizing those together, and I'm going to start making a list over here, and I will try to write legibly and to represent how you've categorized that. I don't want to do the tally yet, because what you say at this table may end up being the same thing that those folks had. And we'll do the tallying at the end, once we've got our list. Then we'll go back through and kind of say, well, how many people had something like this, and have some numbers, okay? So, and we'll just keep going around until we kind of run out of people's list, and we'll see where we are. So, I'm going to pick on this table over here to start just one thing from your list.
That action and a resolution should happen in a timely manner.
Say again, please.
One of the people felt that an action or resolution should happen in a timely manner.
Okay. Okay, now let me ask. No, I don't want to do that. Okay. From this table.
So I guess we've got kind of in categories with both points underneath. What do you want? The category, you want a single bullet point.
Let me hear the category in your first bullet point. Location. So this is a question about location. Tell me your first bullet point.
Location, 80 plus acres on the Durham Lee town line.
Okay, so.
More suggestions, maybe.
That's more like a suggestion, but someone is apparently suggesting a location.
What about the 80 plus acres on the...
Oh, okay. All right.
What about location?
Make a suggestion?
Yes.
Maybe you should have class topics, because we have a lot of questions about land. So if you, at the top of one of those, put land, and then put those underneath, because we have a lot of people asking about land.
Well, let me ask the question like this. So there's a category of questions or comments about land.
Yes.
Are there any other big things? Take a look at your list and see, are there any other big things like that? And then we can do that suggestion, okay? So I'll start one for land, but maybe there's some other things like that. Has anybody got another one they'd like to suggest as a big one?
Well, there's some questions about regionalizing versus not regionalizing, but people are giving suggestions of different towns to consider regionalizing.
Okay, all right. So should I have one say regionalizing or not?
Yeah, we got heads on that too.
All right. Okay, other big ones.
Renovation versus building.
Renovation versus new construction, okay? Other big ones?
Costs.
Costs. Okay, maybe as a whole separate item. We'll try that as a whole separate. Let me look at that. This. Because it's possible those could be addressed in a different
/affordability.
Okay. Okay, other big ones? I heard somebody else making a suggestion.
Maybe one for miscellaneous
doesn't seem to fit anywhere else. Yeah. So let me check. So we've got things about land, things about regionalized or not, things about renovation versus new, cost affordability, any other big ones that people kind of are jumping out at anybody right now?
It's not a lot of data. Just questions about data.
Okay. Yeah. Maybe that can fall under each of these things in terms of the type of information. Okay. So I will do we'll use this one. Miscellaneous that don't seem to fit anywhere else. Okay, so I'm going to go back to these guys, and that was about land, and the question is, what about
the 80 plus acres on the Durham Lee town lot?
Okay. Okay, what was you guys look at your first? Action or resolution in a timely manner. Where does that one go?
Miscellaneous.
Is that a miscellaneous? All right. Something from your group that falls under any one of these categories.
Carpenter's property in addition to current building.
Okay. So in other words. What about adding carpenters to existing land or existing school property?
Yeah.
Okay.
In addition.
Okay. So just say adding carpenters
to
existing property?
Yeah.
Okay. Something from this group?
Should we, after a bullet point, just say how many other people had that? Because we had that for two, and we can knock it off and cross it off.
Yeah, we had three. Yeah,
we had three mentions on the carpenter.
Well, actually, four.
So that's not talking about tallying. Well, here's what will happen is if
I say carpenters and I say carpenters and they say carpenters and they say
well, exactly. If you see something up there already that's already been said, don't say it again. All right. So should I try that and see what happens?
Yes.
Yeah.
All right. So what about the 80 acres on the Durham Lee town line? How many people ran into a comment like that?
Where is it?
One. Okay. Thank you. How many people ran into a comment like adding carpenters to the existing property?
We had four people.
Four, two, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11. Okay? Working good so far. Action resolution in a timely manner.
Yeah, we had said that.
How many?
Timely.
We'll go with two.
Two, three, four, going once, five, six. Does this seem to be working okay?
Yes.
All right. Yes.
That's the inverse question.
Don't rush.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah. We had somebody that said, don't rush the process.
That's the inverse question.
Well, let me ask this. Would it be okay to include under this one anybody who said, don't rush? Or is that different?
That's different.
Okay. All right. So while we're there, how many people ran into a don't rush? Hold up fingers and be careful which fingers you want. One? Anybody else say don't rush? Two? Anybody else say don't rush? Just two. Okay, I'm going to keep going to different groups, and you don't have to stick with a particular category if you got one you like. Just pick one thing from somewhere.
Just tuitioning out the so regional as an odd. We promised to send kids to Portsmouth, Exeter, Oyster River. There's several.
Okay, would it be okay, because people are going to want to vote on this one, if I could list individual districts, or I could list any district that anybody wants to mention? Should we just do anything that anybody wants to mention?
Do that first.
Okay, all right. Portsmouth, Exeter was mentioned. What else was mentioned? Oyster River. Nottingham. Okay, remember, this is what people are mentioning.
Northwood also, right? Northwood?
Barrington.
Northwood, Chris?
Yeah, we don't have
you. Portsmouth? Northwood. Northwood?
And Epping.
Northwood, Epping, Barrington. Any others that are not up there? Are there any towns left in New Hampshire? Okay, so how many people had a suggestion regarding sending, and it's not clear whether we're talking about high school only, high school, middle school, whatever, but just sending kids to any one of these things. Let's see, fingers, three, four, five, six, seven, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17.
And then we had a cut.
Okay.
And then can we do the converse? Because we also had some here that said, do not.
Yes. Okay. All right.
This is from the theme.
We had a couple of those. I thought it was a couple of those.
So. Let me ask, okay, for anybody who suggested basically the opposite of this, regardless of what place we're talking about, don't send. Let's see fingers. One, two, three, eight, nine. I got those. 9, 10, 11.
I mean,
12, 13. Okay? A lot of interest in that issue. Okay. Let's see. I've been up to. I got your table already. Something from these guys. It's not up there yet. Anyone?
Something from us. More as far as land. Something about Susan Conway near the end of New Road.
So people are kind of suggesting
land.
Places for us to just stake out.
More
okay.
Land.
So how about? How many people had other suggestions about particular properties of land? So we had several people with different types of suggestions. All right, so how about, how can I summarize this? Gathering?
All available properties.
Yes.
Okay, some sort of list of all available properties. Okay.
Not just what was on the...
Okay.
Right.
How do we define available
properties? Well, we are not going to worry about that. Okay, so just think of available as possible, okay? Things to consider for somehow.
Land that is for sale.
All right, would this one fall into there? All right, so let me ask, we'll leave carpenters as a thing because that's a specific thing with a specific connection.
And it's a big number.
It's a big number. So let me ask, how many folks had someone suggest some other property in town to take a look at that might be something?
Point of order question.
Yes.
How do I vote if someone's listed? Or
make it four. So let's see, how many different pieces of property got suggested that maybe people want us to look at?
I would like to list the properties.
Yes.
I think we should list the properties.
Yes.
Okay, so.
People were feeling they were left in the dark, so.
Okay, I'm just trying to think. Let me think a second, because here we didn't do individual school districts, and there could be different things.
No, I know, but we have somebody who wants us to list and tell them all sites that may be relative to building a school. So if we don't bullet it, then we're never going to answer their question.
Yeah, but I don't think that we know at this point what all the site possibilities, just because somebody's mentioning it. Somebody mentioned,
right,
like the parking lot. It's the library. I mean, I don't know. I mean, how do they know? Maybe it looks like a good spot, but
well, okay, now let me suggest. Now we're starting to evaluate whether it's a suggestion.
But I mean, as far as
so, what I want to do is, at this point, all I want to get down is that people had questions about specific parcels of land. Now, what we're trying to develop here is we need to provide that sort of information in whatever way we end up doing it. So, what we're doing tonight is not the end of these surveys. We're going to have to go back and take a look at the specifics in here to develop that list.
Well, I want to write them all down.
You are welcome to write them all down, and we'll put you on another subject. Okay? So, just to get a sense of this as a thing, and each different property that you had listed, that to give us an idea how many different things people might have ideas about. So let's see. Go ahead.
We had two.
You had two.
We had
three.
One, two,
five.
Three, four.
We had four.
Nine. Nine times. How many times from you guys did the specific piece of property get mentioned?
Carpenters.
Okay, it's in carpenters already. Good. We're not counting carpenters again. 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Okay.
I did not count my first one that's already up there. So.
Okay,
one more.
So I'm going to add one more. So that's 15, right?
Yep.
So what I'm going to do is, this will eventually get on the list. So this issue got mentioned 15 times with people suggesting, hey, look at X. Okay, we'll have to go back and figure out what X is. All right, over to this group.
Okay, the general question about land, I think a lot of people have the same question, is people need to know why certain parcels of land aren't adequate or acceptable. Because I found that I was thinking of certain lands and found out it wasn't, either it wasn't large enough, there was too much water, you know. So people need to know that kind of information so that we're not all coming back with the same thing over and over again that's not usable.
So let me try to rephrase that. Is people are interested in knowing what are the necessary criteria for the plots of land to be considered from whatever list that we take a look at.
Describe qualifying properties.
What? Pardon me?
Describe qualifying properties.
Does everybody understand what JT just said?
Yeah.
Oh, you do?
Okay. It's the first time
anyone. I want to go with their words to give them a chance to get their words on the list. Right? What? I can't even remember their words. What criteria are necessary for land to have school facilities put on it? I don't think that's best grammar, but is that okay? I said, what criteria are necessary for land to have school facilities put on it?
That's a horrible sentence, but you're right.
All right. Okay, we're in agreement on both of those. Something from this group. Oh, we didn't vote. Okay. So how many people had something relative to the land issue, relative to what the criteria? So let's see how many people had that one. You guys had, how many? Two? Anybody here? There? Here? Over here? Just one, three? Three. Yes.
Just have a question. Don't you think with the high numbers up above that that kind of warrants that everyone really is interested in that final question at the bottom? Because people are suggesting all of these properties and they're not really sure why or why it's not being considered, that ultimately everyone that suggests land is actually wanting to know why it is or isn't on the list.
So as we flesh out the land discussion, that would include reasons why certain properties weren't included in the final tally?
Yes. Okay. I understood you last time. I don't understand you this
time. Okay, so what you're suggesting right now is as you go on, as you start seeing things, you're starting to manipulate the categories and whatever?
I almost feel like everything above pretty much feeds into the final question.
Okay, so what you're doing now is what's good qualitative research. Okay, as you're going, yeah. Okay, this is part of what I do for a living, is when you start parsing out themes of what people say, is you end up changing your mind about how you're going to categorize those in the most efficient way. So, yeah, that may be ultimately what we end up doing here in terms of phrasing that as a thing. Thank you very much. Okay.
This may be a whole new category. I don't have kids. I don't want to pay for anything.
cost or affordability. Okay, it could be two questions, two issues, I guess, right? I don't have kids. How long that's interpreted, therefore, I don't want. It was something. I mean, this is, no. It's their category. So is that an okay issue? How many people had comments relative to, now let's get specific about it. This is specific to folks who may have alluded to essentially not having kids in the district. There may be other reasons of cost that we want to put up here. But let's limit this to one that we're clearly linked to. I don't have the kids in there at this time. Anybody have that? You guys had how many? One, two, three, four.
Let's talk about taxes and your world cost.
I don't know how else to interpret that.
He said to keep everything exactly the same because he didn't have kids and there wasn't.
So however you want to interpret that, we'll eventually get everything up. So am I including that? A different one. Okay, we'll keep different. I got four, just four. Okay.
Add one more. I think we had another one that was sort of cut off, but
clearly there's 60. This is not an exact count. Okay, so let's see. We've been around everybody at least once. So back over here. What else isn't up here already?
How about respect earlier votes? In other words, I got a couple comments that said, hey, we've already voted twice. They said no twice. Go away.
Should I put it here? Okay, did anybody else have a comment of the sort that we kind of made a couple of decisions in this direction we should be revisiting? So how many did you have?
One?
Anybody else? Anybody else? Two?
We had somebody said they want to know the total cost of the whole package, including all elementary additions and purchases of property and all high school costs together. I want to know how much everything is going to cost.
Basically, they were saying that it was too vague. What they were given was too vague. There's no land, no cost, just so.
Right. So really it's a sense of wanting to know
detail.
A breakdown of cost and looking at all of the possible pieces related to that. Is that the sense of what you got?
Yeah.
How much?
Total, I mean, not just the high school or not this, but if they're doing stuff at elementary school, they want to know what the total picture, what we're looking at.
Okay, so let me try this.
Figuring in, core factor.
Okay, so comments or questions about, if you look at maybe total, instead of a project, could I say needs or maybe not? Well, okay, as long as we know what we're talking about. So how much does a total project cost if you're thinking about what has to be done with respect to high school, what may have to be done with respect to elementary school, what may have to be done with respect to land, and the, each of those. So is that the sense of that particular
yes.
thing? Okay, so how many had something like that? It says all of these things we may be interested in doing, total cost of those things.
And are you talking
one?
New versus... Revamping.
Well, I would assume you can include new or renovated,
renovated
or whatever.
Okay.
Okay.
Right.
One, three, that's four. Six. All right.
The direct cost comparison between remodeled and built-in.
Okay.
No, Chris, that's an connecting that category? Or is that cost?
Right.
Yeah, it's cost.
Okay.
This is direct.
Okay.
Well, okay.
They were asking for a specifically, I'm sorry.
Okay, I see what you mean. All right, so I'm going to make the executive decision to put it under cost.
Right.
Okay. So direct, and maybe, would it be useful to say, and you tell me whether you'd like to say it this way or not, direct comparisons of likely options? Or is that saying too much to what those folks said?
The question, they want to know the price of remodeling versus the cost of building new.
Direct costs of remodel versus new. Okay. So anybody who had questions specific, oh, go ahead.
No, I'm just going to say, I have a question that kind of goes along with that.
Okay.
Where a person asks, what kind of help was available from the government for, you know, like what kind of help in
okay.
renovation as opposed to
well, let's
building.
Let's suggest that as a separate thing
okay.
so we don't forget it. And we'll go to that one next. Okay. So anybody who had a specific request for looking at the cost of remodeling whatever versus building new whatever, you guys had one.
About what?
Two. Remodeling versus new.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, mine's not versus new.
Okay, let's keep it remodeling versus new for the moment. So four, I think. Seven. Two. Nine. Okay, and then the next one is?
That the amount of help you might get from the government.
If you see my hand, go up with your hand. If you see my hand, go up with your hand. Stop talking. If you see my hand, go up. If you see my hand, up, put your hand up and stop talking. Okay, what I'm doing here is a little thing sometimes to do when working with groups is people get engaged and stuff. And so what I'll try to do instead of yelling, I don't want to yell, is I'll stick my hand up if I'm trying to get my attention or if I think someone else can't be heard. And when your hand goes up, your lips get closed. Okay. And it quiets down pretty quickly. So.
Okay, amount of help you might expect for the cost of building from the government as opposed to the amount of help you might get from the government if you were remodeling.
So
and I'm sure those people are different.
Did they say what type of government?
Well,
state.
Okay.
But I'll let me also throw federal in there
because
sometimes we get questions about that.
Federal too, because there should be federal funds available. But on the state of federal health, renovation versus building.
Okay. All right. So, folks who had comments about how much or what's available from the state or federal government if you're dealing with renovation or new or either one of those. So if anybody's asking about what's available as help from the state or feds, let's count. So you guys had one. Five.
We got one over here.
Six. Where did that one come from? Oh, that was back there. Oh, that's right, it went from there to there. Okay. Okay, you folks back there. Anything else up to cover for us?
The only thing we have is for the renovation.
Okay.
We have no four. I don't want to say four, but
okay, I'm confused.
Okay, wait. Six.
So should I have added six to this? Because I don't.
There's people who said they preferred.
I put up three things.
Okay, let's clarify for a second. So that was when I asked about state federal help for renovation versus new. Is this a new category or something different than?
This one's new. The one I was telling you about the six is for the renovation.
Okay. So what is the exact question or issue that people are asking?
They just want to renovate.
Okay.
Prefer to renovate.
Okay. Renovation. So the question or comment is about, hey, what about renovation?
Yes.
Okay. And basically the details of what that would be, et cetera, et cetera.
Renovation, I put renovation in addition maybe because we have people that want to.
Okay, so is it okay if I add addition to renovation?
Yes.
Okay. Okay, so how many folks found comments where people asked about why can't we renovate or add or both? Two, five.
Five.
10, 18, 22, 25, 27, 29. Okay, we're testing my editing ability. 29. Okay. Let's see. So you guys. Another one for somewhere?
Do I have one?
Well, let's maybe under miscellaneous, but let's hear what the issue is.
Well, there's quite a few. We want to just them all and just generalize them.
But it might be worth generalizing.
Because you want to make sure that they know that they're.
Yes. Yeah.
We had a lady who sent in quite a few concerns regarding the special ed. Her comments were that she felt the elementary school did fine, but however, she has heard things through the high school that they were concerned about updating facilities, handicapped accessible activities, bathrooms. I don't know if she's been in school or not, but she has concerns for the classroom for visually impaired or light and noise sensitivities, issues with kids. Special needs, athletic activities. She was very concerned about programs with special ed with the social skills and with inside the building. What do you call it?
Integration.
Yeah. Integration, but not just that too, but also that the building itself
Okay, so let me try this. So this is relative to, it's relative to all relative construction. Questions about special education needs relative to the physical facility. In other words, how those issues may impact decisions that go into construction. Is that fair, Janice?
Well, you might want to. She mentioned some programs, right? Well, you might want to just put physical facilities dash programs.
Programs, right.
Okay.
She mentioned some programs for therapy.
Okay, does everybody understand what that category is? All right. So anybody who had a comment that was relative to the specific way that special education expectations affect decisions about physical facilities and the programs that have to be there. Let's see how many fingers we got. None. Thinking? How many did you guys have?
We had the one.
Just the one, but
multiple.
No. Anything?
None?
None? None? None? Okay. just one, a bunch of subheadings, but it's up there.
Yeah.
Let's see, these guys, anything else that's not up here yet?
I think one that was built new, just in general, the building new facility.
They just said build new.
Well, they have this grand scheme of, it sounds like it's, repair this one facility and temporarily ship kids out and then build a nice new facility.
Okay, so how about addressing questions relative to the process that would have to happen to do it? Is that fair?
Renovated
stages. So build new
stages.
Build new. Okay. How about addressing facilities issues in stages? Thinking that we're thinking about a piece of something in terms of building now, a piece of something next. Is that a way of saying it?
Yeah. Or phased renovation approach?
A phased renovation?
Yeah, renovation still sounds in stages. Sounds like this one's building a new school.
Building in stages, okay.
Yeah,
so
we had one of those build a new school attached to that side,
yeah,
and then eventually tear this side down.
Yeah.
So basically, what's the parking lot over there
okay.
now would be
so
over here.
This would be questions about staging, renovation or additions. Is it all about renovations and additions, or are they also talking about just separate?
We're talking about renovating, how to do it.
Okay,
like
the mechanism. Okay. So let's try this on. Is anybody who had comments for folks who said that there might be a way of managing this by doing it in smaller chunks, some sort of staging, whether they're talking about adding something or renovating something or even a something new and then changing? Anybody who had something like that, we get a sense of people wanting that. So you can, I don't know where this started from. Two. Seven. Seven? Any over there? Seven. Okay.
8:30.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Oh.
And she's not a planner. Benny Huckle's been here all the time. That came from the guest.
Oh, thank you. There was a number of people that were concerned about whether we build new or renovate, separating the middle school
yes.
from the high school.
Yes.
Okay, so relative to this is now grade level decisions.
Separation.
Grade level separations.
Yes.
Okay, so if I say questions about grade level separation, is that?
Or junior, senior, I mean, I don't know what junior is.
It depends on the
size.
In some places it's
How about grade level separation options?
Yes.
That's good.
Okay. Five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, something that's not up here yet.
A couple people have concerns about renters. They feel they're not paying taxes to the schools.
Miscellaneous or costs?
Costs.
Okay, so
too many renters are not paying taxes.
Non-property owners, is that a good way? Okay, so like information about like the percentage or distribution,
yes.
something about non-property.
Cost of supporting non-property owners in the school district.
Non-property owners.
Okay,
non-property rental offense. Okay, so what I put up here, if this is okay, is non-property or rental, how that affects taxes and maybe number of children?
Sure.
Okay, so how many folks had something like that? One, four, four, okay, all right. I'm back over here again. Anything not up here yet?
Somebody suggested a voucher model, so that every Newmarket student gets a dollar amount.
Okay, so I'm going to say, I'm just going to cover up everything but the title here. Under cost and affordability, role of voucher type system. Is that okay? So anybody else say anything about a voucher type system? I guess that money goes with the kid or something like that. So how many? One? Anybody else? Anybody else?
You mean like more like tuition based?
Yeah. Okay. Okay. Anybody else have that? Two?
Your kid costs the school district $11,000 a year. Here it is. Take them someplace.
Take them someplace. Yeah. Put them where you want.
So
them.
As opposed to as a wholesale, all right. Kids with a contract with a district, this is individual version of that.
Of course, to go to Portsmouth here, it's 13,000.
Okay, we're evaluating. One. Okay, what else is not up here yet?
One of the needs defined for matching the requirements to get state funding.
No. It's qualifying properties.
No, it's not. It's making sure that we don't spend $2 to get $1 back in the state.
Okay, say that again,
please. Defining the needs before matching the requirements to get state funding.
Okay, should that go here? I don't know where else to put it.
Yes, that's the cost.
Defining.
Making sure we're not spending $2 just so we can get, you know, 20 cents and aid.
Defining needs. Just say it out, I'm going to write it down.
Before comparison to state requirements for funding.
I missed some.
Defining needs. Before.
It comes down to everything we do, we say, we do on a grander scale, that the scale is the state aid. We have to have so many acres, so many square feet.
Oh.
So we want to know what our needs are before we match them to what the state says we have to have.
Define minimum expenditure for state aid.
$16 million, the state could do $8 million, but if you spend $10 million, the state only can do $2 million, which basically means you make all the same, but you spend all
the money. It's relative to get state funding. There are certain expectations you're expected to have. What you're saying, let's look at our needs first, and then take a look at the expectations. Okay, so anybody who had a comment relative to defining local needs and then looking at the state requirements, anything like that? You guys had one, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Okay? Something else from you guys?
One about the demographics. Has the town studied the demographics of Newmarket to know if the size of the student body will grow over the years? It's my understanding that there really is not a lot of land left to build homes on in Newmarket. How does this affect the town's need for a new school? And another one right along that same line, basically saying it has already been stated that due to the fact Newmarket is built out, that the school population will either stay steady or decrease.
Okay, I put in two things. Does it sound like two things? So, how many people had something that related to, let's take a look at what the demographic, let's get some data on demographics projecting for the future. Three, four, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 9, okay, that was this part. The other part, and it hadn't come up before we were talking about land, it's kind of like the sense of, at some point, you may be out of land. And so people may want specific data about that. So did anybody else talk about the issue of land being built out or in terms of that thing?
I think that that is, that the town is built out was directly related to the demographics based on this. It's already, it's been stated that the Newmarket is built out, so the school population will not increase or will stay steady.
All right, I'll put it where you guys want it. All right, so does that add any for anybody if it talks about building out?
Yeah, 1 minute.
We've got one more, so
one
yeah.
More. All right. Anything else? Oh, we exhausted the table. All right. Nothing? Nothing more? Anything else from back there? Anything else here?
I was just going to say tax is another big concern, taxes. Then that goes under cost. Affordability to live in the town, you know, folks are feeling as though they can't afford to live here any longer.
So let's ask, yes.
Can I ask something? We have one here that says, maybe a referendum to select the top three alternating alternatives and examine these three in greater detail.
Okay, that's kind of like once we've made some decisions, how it's going to actually get decided.
Yeah.
Not to say that that's not a way of thinking about it, but this is kind of more we need to do the information first. So I don't want to get into our various ways of doing that, but we won't forget that.
Another one. For the past 5 years, we've voted in budgets to do repairs on the school. Where have these repairs been made? As we don't see anything changes in this for you.
Okay, where would you like me to place them?
I don't know.
How about under, how about renovations versus here? Or is that more a budget issue? Miscellaneous? Okay, so where has budgeted some money for repairs? Is that a fair question about what you just said? Okay. Howdy people ran into a comment that asked about, we've had money in the budget for repairs and maintenance, why is that not been taken care of? 1, 2, 3, 4. I forgot to come back to this. How many people specifically just said like, taxes, tax rate, even if they provided no more detail? 6? 9, 10, 14, 18, 19. Okay, I'm just going to go to anybody who hasn't gotten, who's missing something that's not up here yet. Anybody, there's a category item not up here.
With the repairs, somebody also asked, what are the exact repairs that need to be done? And basically said that, you know, you see all in the area that people say they can't build, but then you'll, you know, then they'll see like the extra courthouse now has all
businesses
in it. The
old Dover Junior High couldn't be revamped, it was no good, and da da da. And they built the middle school, and now it's the police department, the city council offices, and a senior center. And in addition to that, the old courthouse in Exeter could not be renovated, it was no good, absolutely had to be torn down, and now it's completely gone. So I think that, a lot of people were.
Okay, so no evaluation. Okay. Right. Okay. It's 20 minutes to 9. I want to make sure we get to an endpoint that makes sense. So I want to finish this comment coming from this table. So it was information about comparisons with other local public building renovations.
No, that's not where it was going.
That's not where it's
going. Okay, well then tell me where it's going.
It's basically saying, I think that people were feeling like you were trying to scare us into like they're going to shut the school down, and they just don't think that bad, first of all.
Okay, so what's the issue is, what's the question?
They're saying that this can't be renovated, and a lot of people think it can be renovated.
Okay,
I think Portsmouth High School is older than
Okay, so it's not just the other, the fact that other, well, I was kind of pulling off, you were saying other things can be done, why not this?
Right.
Okay.
If other buildings can be renovated, why can't this?
Anything can be renovated.
Okay, how many people had a comment relative to really feeling, why is it that this can't be renovated? And really focusing on that as an issue. How many?
We had one or two.
Two. Three. The others? Four? Five? Okay. Anything else missing? Yes?
Like the costs listed as a per pupil rate for building for whatever the options are.
Okay. So did anybody have a comment relative to we'd like to see the data on a per pupil basis? Is that fair? Okay. So comment. One. Anybody else? Per pupil cost data one. Anything else missing?
We had one that they just wanted to see an ultimate yes, no vote on if they should do a school or not brought to the town. So I'm not sure how that
Okay, I'm going to say that that's kind of another mechanism type, like the choice type, which was suggested back here.
Yeah,
I'm not sure we're ready to deal with that issue yet. Well, okay, let me rephrase that. Let me say it's kind of like how options put, let me just try this on for voters. Because that's really a separate sort of issue. That's relative to the three or four options versus the yes, no type option. So that's ultimately how the vote aspect gets done. So I'm assuming I got at least two for that. Anybody else have anything that said how are the options placed before the voters? So I got one, three, four, five, six. Anything else missing?
I'm going to take out all three of mine real quick.
All right, let's see what you got.
One to ensure that it's going to be a broad curriculum.
I'm going to do this. Okay, so we're going to say, is this miscellaneous? Are these all miscellaneous?
Yes.
Okay, I'm just going to call this miscellaneous down here. Okay, ensure broad curriculum. So it's kind of like, sounds like we'd like information about curriculum. Kind of.
Yeah, kind of.
Can I poll people on that one?
Sure.
How many people had something about the breadth or details of the curriculum, not maybe relative to special ed? One, three, four. Okay, what's your next one?
Avoid educational fads. IEP laptops.
Okay. All right. So this would be kind of like how do you outfit the school to support a particular curriculum if you make decisions where you have to have it, whatever. So, did anybody else have something like that? That's kind of like the details of the building.
Well, the thing I had about the curriculum was the school. Of this size, really couldn't offer the type of curriculum that they would like to see, you know, like AP courses.
Okay, so how does school size affect curriculum decisions?
Yeah.
Which kind of relates to some other things. How many people had something about how school size affects curricular decisions? There's one. Two.
I would like to see a comparison of educational results from Newmarket versus local school districts.
Okay. Educational outcomes, Newmarket versus other. How many people had a comment relative looking at our school data?
Yeah.
One, relative to others. One, two, three. Three. Four. Okay. Okay, everybody take a deep breath for a second. Deep breath for a second, and I want to see what else before we kind of next. So if we had
apparently, somebody said that the original blueprints for the elementary school were bigger, and if this is true, we're not going to get that project. Large amount of elementary school, moving the sixth graders back, and saying it says in here, you know, not believe sixth graders should be in high school. They are separated, but they are not. And there is a drug problem in the high school. The sixth graders should not be in high school.
Okay. I've written this so that I can read it. Okay. Did anybody else say anything like, didn't we have blueprints that allowed the elementary school to be bigger? Anybody else comment on that? I'll just comment. That issue, I mean, that question has been out there, so it's a valid question to be out there. It's not just strange. Okay, so I'm going to put one, but okay, the issue about grade separation we have there. So, yeah.
I was just curious if you had a rough count of how many pieces of paper we evaluated to give some weight to the numbers.
Okay, so hang on for a second because that's you're anticipating exactly. Let me see if there are any other things that I want to write up to the list of information. Yes, Ethel.
Can I go back to the time of stratum?
Yes.
The stratum tech could be a possibility.
Okay, so land?
No, for options for our house school, our size has curriculum. Our first curriculum, is that what you're trying to say, though? Like if we
but she's talking about the New Hampshire Technical Institute in Stratum, the building.
That's right.
Okay. So I'm just going to I'm gonna stick it under land, but because I got no world to put it in. Stratum
Newmarket
Tech building. Anybody else have anybody who raised a question about the Stratum Tech building? One. Two, I assume. Anything else that's not on the list? Yes.
There was a question about, somebody wanted to know, have there been regular building inspections here at the school? And the question also was, would the state step in if the conditions were that bad?
Okay, so how many people had a comment relative to basically state inspection of the buildings and had that been done and the ramifications of that? So one.
Anything else
in this?
Yeah.
Anything else? Okay, one more.
It said if a new facility was to be built, then there should be a new facility committee. Because the other committee already had ideas already perceived.
Okay, so now we're talking about the mechanism of from. Let me suggest that was one of the next things on our next list was to think about the structure of a decision-making recommendation group.
So well, it's a comment there, so we want to make sure.
So it's a comment. Okay, so I'm going to put it under miscellaneous as structure of facilities committee going forward and membership. So things related to that. Anybody else say anything about membership and structure of the committee going forward? That beyond us. That's not us, but it's beyond us. How many? One from over here, I assume. Anybody else raise that issue? One? Okay. Given the time, I'm going to make an executive decision to say that we captured almost everything or nearly everything. So let me think about my original intention and where we are. Now, the other thing we managed to do at the same time, I'm going to go back to your suggestion. What I want to do is at your table, I want you to count up what does it look like? How many different submissions do you think you have? Okay, so let's just get an overall tally of how many we think we have.
bad things.
Yeah, the emails are important.
That's it.
Well, I think in the next meeting, I just don't stop doing something.
I also, just so you know, I know some
people. Okay, hang on. We're going to get there. All right, how many?
Six.
Seven. 13.
Five.
How many?
There's 18.
Please. How many? Six.
Seven.
13.
Five.
18.
Nine.
27.
Seven.
34. 46. 56. 63. All right, the last thing I wanted, since we're very close to time, is real quickly, I can't do it in as much detail as I want to. First of all, I will organize this so that it can report out the information, okay? It's not clear yet, at least to me, exactly where we go from that. I think we have to talk about that. But let me ask you something, since we went through this process, we have some indication of this stuff right here. Remember, we had goals for the process. Okay, remember the discussion last time. Why did we do this? I wrote down from our notes, we had two things. We wanted to engage the entire community, and we wanted to allow for free expression of ideas. So what I want to know is, and in like 1 minute at your table, I want you to talk about, did we achieve the two objectives? The free expression, did we achieve the engage the entire community? Talk at your table for 1 minute, and I'm just going to ask people what they thought.
It would be important to know how many mailings were done.
No, we're not going to do that. I just want to know. Engage all or free expression.
I think that the engage all is.
You make your own interpretation. All right, I want to hear what people are talking about. How many people thought that folks were allowed to freely express their ideas? You did put your hands up. Okay, all right, so in the sense of, did we achieve the idea of allowing people to express the idea in what we saw people agree with that? Okay, now let's talk to what extent did each table think we engaged the community? Briefly, yes or no?
No.
Split?
No.
No? To the extent possible?
Yeah, I think so. It started to get people involved. 63 more than we had last week.
Okay.
But we still
don't.
No. No? No? No. Okay. So, remember, we thought this was a really good idea last time.
It is. It is a good idea.
Marketing. It's still a good idea. So what I want us to think about, since time is close, is we had good hopes for the information we might get. We got information. We had the opportunity to talk about it. It's possible that everybody else's opinion is similar to this, but we don't know. So we need to think about this because so far we've been engaged. Now let me just, curiosity, how many people here sent in something? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. Subtract 21 from that.
One-third.
All right? So in reality, you had 40 people who were not already engaged in it. Now, just for a record, how many surveys did we get back 2 years ago when we did a survey? Kathy, how many surveys did we get back 2 years ago when we sent it out?
About 150.
So we have an issue in terms of how to get the engagement that you would like to have. I don't have an answer to that.
Is the moral of the story that we just wasted the last 2 hours of our life?
Well, let's think of it this way. If this is a reasonable sampling of, now what we didn't do is, I want to get details. All right. If this is a reasonable sampling of opinion, and if there was a reasonable, you know, people who responded who really wanted to, it may be that you've got all the issues you want. Now, the problem is the numbers are the things that are more likely to be suspect because you may have hit certain people, not hit other people for whatever reason. So the numbers I wouldn't rely on greatly, but the number of responses is meaningful. The fact that they made the comments is meaningful. But putting like a value on the comments in terms of what's more important than other, that's a little bit more risky.
Can I ask two questions? One is can we please encourage people who have not submitted their survey because they forgot it in their mail or whatever, to continue submitting their surveys or input to this committee, number one.
Okay.
And number two, one of my friends did not receive one in the mail, and
two of people,
I don't know what the heck happened, but not everyone who is a homeowner mm-hmm. received one in the mail.
But in terms of process, something got sent to every mail drop. At least something was intended to get sent to every
right.
mail.
Over 4,000 were dropped at mailboxes and or at the post office. 4,000.
Oh.
So 4,000 pieces of paper went out. Whether they got to where they were intended, different issue, but 4,000 went out and we effectively got 40 independent responses. So let's follow up on the issue here is, would one useful thing to do be to encourage folks from in some manner to please continue, if you missed the deadline or whatever, to please continue sending in stuff.
My original copy of this said, yeah. The one that I have said yeah. on the bottom, it said, any questions or comments received after May 23rd will be addressed at a later date, and that's been...
Okay, well, with so in other words...
It was supposed to say, and they had to continue to send them.
Okay. So we can at least use the website.
I just filled mine out today.
Okay. All right. And you wrote it up. Okay. So there's a thing that we can do to try to build the engagement. So in the last 2 minutes, I'm going to ask for any other insights that folks may want to say.
This is the information that should be in the paper tomorrow. You know, that we sent out 4,000, only 63 people responded, and 23 of them were sitting in the room.
Can we have some cooperation from the media on that? They can, you know, send me your email.
Where are your school questionnaires? We only received 63 out of 4,000.
So let me suggest...
I think that's a little pushed.
So let me suggest, instead of being unsubtle, everybody in here probably knows somebody who probably didn't respond. So the next time you run into a neighbor or you run into whomever, ask them, hey, did you get the survey? And they say, what or whatever. Is there a blank survey on the website? Is there a... Well, let's say this way. If you guys know the question. If people had questions or comments, they can put them in writing. They don't have to attach their names to them, as Eudena says, and they need to get them. They can give them to you, and you can bring them in. They can go to in the other same places that we said before. So that's a thing that would be valuable to try to build engagement. Okay, so there's the thing. Now...
They should have a deadline to get those in.
Well, how long? Yes, sir.
Maybe what this is as the committee takes more shape, this becomes a springboard.
Maybe,
this begins filling back from the committee into the community, or at the very least, here you go, here's your starting point, committee, and see where it goes. And then it's open-ended from there on, because if we say, you know what, we want your deadline, if you don't communicate by this date, we don't care.
Yeah.
Then we're in the same boat we were before. And the other time, if we expect at any point some kind of scientific data to come out of this, we're fooling ourselves because we're never going to get a scientific sample.
But we could take these questions and create a scientific sample and maybe via phone.
breaking these down into basic questions to calling and say, would you be more in favor of a renovation or a new building?
I agree.
Would you be, we can do a phone, we can take these, you know, these, this set of questions to create some sort
of... When you have money figured down, people will reply back. People want to know what the cost is going to be. Then you're going to see more than 63 people coming.
So I need to know, a couple things. First of all, one thing we decided to do was keep advertising the need for and desire to have information coming from people. Second thing is, at some point, we're going to have to figure out whether we can use this in other ways mechanistically to get more detailed information. I don't think we're there yet. Third thing is, I want to know when we're meeting again.
Just one other suggestion, maybe when you get the minutes of compile this and it's on the website, maybe if we just take that amount of information and maybe send it to our, you know, 5 or 10 friends and say, hey, this was really interesting, why don't you look it over? You know, just that it's another way to get a little bit of more information out there, maybe more interest.
Kathy, did you want to say something?
I don't think they're going to look at the whole.
Everything that you've done the last 2 weeks has been sent via email. So the minutes from the last 2 meetings will be sent out to you. So
you could forward.
You can forward it to whoever you'd like.
All right, so here's one issue. If you didn't get the previous minutes, there's something wrong with your email connection.
I got an email saying the meeting, don't forget, the meeting is such and such, but there was
no attachment.
You should have gotten attached to
it. Okay.
No,
so,
it would have been like 2 weeks ago that I sent it.
Okay, well let me suggest that we're going to have to be vigilant to not just rely on people knowing that they've done things, is you have to be vigilant on the other end and say, I didn't get my notes from that meeting, maybe I should figure out what the issue is, because it could be emails get screwed up or spam filters or you name it. So originally we collected email information and you're on a list, and hopefully that's what's done to get stuff out. So if you're not getting it, we need to figure out what's happened. Also, the notes will get onto the website too. So if you get an email with the attachment, it's public information, you can forward it to as many people as you want. And that's one way to try to get information. When are we meeting next? Okay, I need to know whether the next thing is, we talked about the possibility of a forum. Maybe this stuff is the basis for going ahead with that, or maybe you feel that we need to think a little bit more before we do that. It's not my decision, it's the decision of this group as to where we think we are. Do we need to think about this some more?
Our participating numbers are still too low for me.
To go to that sort of setting and try to start answering questions. How long do you think it might be to try to provide this sort of information? And who's doing it? All right, that's not going to happen in the next 3 weeks. So there's an issue with person power to try to get to the sort of detail that might reasonably answer questions for folks in a reasonable way. And if you go in with, I got answers to a couple things, but we haven't had time to do all these other things, that doesn't send the right kind of message either. So I'm going to suggest that and you don't have to agree with me, that we may need to get together as a group again to process this a little bit more, to try to figure out how this is. Because if what we say is, we would like the superintendent and the school board and the folks in the school district to do all this stuff, how many people are they still have status quo to maintain? We may have to take on some of these tasks. Sending it to someone else to do is going to be a bottleneck. So I think we need to think very carefully about how it is we're going to get to the things that we want to get to. Because in the past, I've been on plenty of facilities committees, it ends up being a few heads trying to do everything, and it becomes problematic to get the sort of result that you'd like to get. Yes?
It's almost
10:30,
and I have to go out to the date for the meeting.
Okay, date for the meeting.
June 14th.
June 14th? What day of the week is that, please?
Thursday.
Thursday? Is that a school board night? Not necessarily. So I've had a suggestion for June 14th. So I don't see anybody saying no. Thursday, June 14th at 7 p.m. Someone suggested Thursday, and I'm just going with the initial suggestion.
How does it work? We're going to have to answer questions, right? But can answer, is somebody going to condense those questions on?
I will take responsibility for organizing these in a way that hopefully presents it in a way that people can look at it in a sensible way. I won't add things, I won't reinterpret things.